Hi, Peter. Good to see you. Welcome on board.
Hi, John. Nice to see you. Your vessel looks good and well maintained. I got a good impression when looking down from the helicopter.
I saw that you also had the two cargo surveyors with you on the helicopter. That's great. And you must be the new trainee. Welcome on board. It looks like you are going to have a nice and easy start with STS transfer. You are in very experienced company.
Well, this operation should be a good opportunity to learn a lot. Maybe you could give us an update on the situation on the Mary, John. I suppose everything is perfectly organized according to MARPOL Annex 1. And how about the recommendation in the STS transfer guide? Are we following all of these?
Of course, Peter. We have received all the necessary documents, including checklist number 1, from the operator. And we have notified the national and local authorities of the operation at least 48 hours prior to commencement as required. Furthermore, the master on the Rio and I have agreed on the transfer area and gone through the obligatory risk assessment and contingency plans.
Great. And what about the equipment?
Your company's service boat delivered the cargo hoses and fenders yesterday evening, and it's all rigged and ready for inspection.
Okay, when we're finished here, I'll start the inspection. But first, I think we should show Nick the transfer area. Look here, Nick. The location is very well suited for an STS transfer, with both ships underway. For future reference, I think it would be a great idea to have a list of the considerations when choosing transfer area. Could you draft the list? It's a very good and safe location. But what about the Rio? Is she also ready for action?
That's what I've been told. The master is Michael Jones, a very nice guy who also knows what to do. We have a good communication. In fact, he was also master on the Rio, the first time these two ships performed an STS transfer. And that was very fortunate because the preparation of the operation was complicated. As you know, they had to rebuild the Rio in order to fulfill the safety requirements and to establish compatibility with the Mary.
Yes, it is important to ensure that the ships are compatible in both design and equipment before a ship-to-ship transfer. Maybe we should give Nick some details regarding the compatibility.
Let me show you. I have gathered all the required information regarding the operation in this portfolio. Now, to the left, we have the Rio, as she was 3 years ago, and to the right, the Mary. And as the Rio is a tanker over 160,000 deadweight tons, she should also have closed fairleads and full-sized mooring bits within 35 metres fore and aft of the centre of the starboard manifold in order to be approved as an STS transfer ship. Also, the cargo hose support at the vessel rail had to be modified and strengthened. They did a great job, and, until now, neither we nor other ships have experienced any problems with transfers to the Rio. Here, you can see the compatibility list of the equipment that has been checked for the two ships.
There is now 45 minutes to the pre-operational meeting with the crew, and I have some calls to do. Could you run through the papers in the portfolio that the master has prepared before the pre-operational meeting in the meantime, just so you get an overview of what information is needed before the commencement of the STS operation? Great. We need to check the risk assessment and contingency plans. What do you think are the most important issues in this case? Could you also take a closer look at the risk assessment and contingency plans made? It is always important to check the standard risk assessments and adjust the risk assessments to the particular situation. Then we also need the contingency plan, which is extremely important for the safety and efficiency of this operation. Both ships have their own contingency plan worked out by the respective owner-operator. This is a contingency manual which contains detailed instructions on how to act in case of severe incidents or accidents. Can you tell me what incidents or accidents we need to be prepared for in an STS operation? Yes? Collision? Fire on board? Man overboard? Piracy attacks? Oil pollution or release of gas on gas carriers? Grounding? Should definitely be part of the contingency plan. The contingency plan also contains an emergency reporting contact list. In addition, both vessels have their own shipboard oil pollution emergency plan, SOPEP, and OPA 90, Vessel Response Plan VRP, with all reporting contact. For this STS operation, the company and ship-specific contingency plan are active, and the masters must comply accordingly. In addition, there will be a contingency plan covering the specific STS operation. The alerting telephone numbers will be 1. National Point of Contact. This is to the authority permitting the operation in their coastal waters. 2. Fire Department on shore. 3. Agents. 4. Cleanup contractors in case of oil spill. 5. Supporting organizations for other emergencies. The organizers, TB Fender Care, have arranged several of these tasks. But as the person in overall advisory control, I will normally be the person who makes alerting calls in case of incidents or accidents. At the same time, the masters will have to report according to their company's policy. In our meeting later with both chief officers on board the Rio, we will discuss the contingency reporting procedures and agree upon reporting between the ships and externally. The contingency plan with telephone list should also be posted and well known by the duty deck officers. Okay, so let me sum up. The information that we need to deal with in this organizing phase of the operation is between you and the STS organizer agent. Instructions and area details. Provide detailed information about cargo, equipment, compatibility, and conditions. Checklist number 1 filled in. Between you and the other ship. Who is in control and agreed working language? Risk assessments and contingency plans. The checklists can be used to support you in the planning and to ensure that all relevant safety factors are considered.